Good day, everyone. I am Dr. Raymond Oliver Cruz, and in behalf of PaperKat Books, I would like to greet the romance writers of the Philippines on your successful 2021 RomCon convention. So this is my first time to address all of you, and thank you and congratulations again from PaperKat Books. For this session, I would like to share with you some of the stories behind the book that I have. So this is Unrequited. So this is my initial foray into self-publishing, and it's actually a book on it's a poetry book that was written during the pandemic. You know, during the pandemic, we have more time for writing and for, you know, being creative. And I guess it's not all negative. Sometimes all of these challenges will bring out creative nature in us. And of course, the book was conceptualized way before the pandemic, but the writing process and its completion, of course, occurred last year, okay? Just when we had the crisis, which is COVID-19. So as a physician, of course, when you read through Unrequited, you will see that the romance part is also interspersed with some medical background, of course. And, you know, medicine is also full of stuff that is, you could consider that romanticism is also present in the medical field. So kung meron mang nasa medical field sa inyo, I'm sure you would probably agree that, you know, you can still have some good relationships while you're in training or while you're studying medicine. Anyway, what I would like to do, of course, is to share with you some excerpts also of Unrequited, and maybe you would also find the motivation to maybe write poetry in the future, or if you're writing poetry, then maybe I could also give you an idea with how the thought process is. Of course, it's not a Shakespearean level poetry, but I really have incorporated a lot of emotion, and it's important also that the reader would also find some lessons to reading in the passages. Okay, so maybe I'll just read some excerpts here. I'd like to start off with the prologue. So, prologue is The War in Heaven. This will start off the story. There was once a fight in heaven among the different brethren. They came to this assembly to plan for eternity. The leader wants to bear his plan, to uplift each and every man. Each spirit shall have flesh and bones, and experience all its moans and groans. With this came forth the angel of light, offering things with all his might, that not a soul remains forsaken, as long as all the praise he'll take. Nobody will be left behind, no pain, no hardship, nothing of its kind. For I ensure that love and life will not result in grief and strife. So there were murmurs, some with screams, opinions laid in all extremes. For if to veer we never let, man won't do things they might regret. Let's cut freedom with intention, stop this fruitless mind commotion. Bring to pass, angel of light, use your power, flash your might. Not one soul should feel the pain of desolation or disdain. Let love be a blend plain decree, share the heart for all to see. And if this plan will be rejected, I suggest they be ejected. For no one should be made to choose a path where there's a chance to lose. But then came forth the begotten Son, who simply said, "Thy will be done." With this the Father said with glee, "May men on earth always be free. You will taste both life and death. Pain will lurk with every breath, but my love will be with thee and always will for eternity." Okay, so that's the prologue part. And of course, it will start off the idea of what is in the book with regards how the story unfolds with someone having thoughts of loving someone. Okay, so let's proceed with maybe one of the. By the way, it's written in such a way that there are segments. So that's the prologue, and then the first segment is on the part "Love is beautiful." It really is at the start, but then. You know, it's not always a bed of roses. And the next part would be on love is painful. And then the next would be love is merciful. It will end with a portion on love is hope. So it's a collection of, I think these are 43 poems, okay? Including a prologue and an epilogue. I'll also be reading one part of the segment on love is beautiful. It's called Flowers. Today I saw some vibrant flowers bloom beneath the sun's great powers. Its beauty springs like heaven's gift that every soul it may uplift. With this grand sight, I think of you, of where you are and what you do, of lives you touch with your caress, and all the things I can't profess. Undying is my admiration, longing for your kind attention. Spare some time and glance at me, so you will see what I can do. Like blooms that take the blues away, only you can make my day. For when I get to hold you dear, all my hurts will disappear. That's one of the poems in the portion, Love is Beautiful. It's actually the third poem in the series. As I said, after the Love is Beautiful comes the Love is Painful. Of course, something happens. The question will be, as I mentioned here in the book, so a man falls in love, he is so happy, love is beautiful, but he soon realizes that his feelings are unrequited and he falls into despair. Love becomes painful, then he gets infected with a deadly virus and he then thinks life will all end. So remember, I wrote this during the pandemic, so there's some inspiration with regards to being infected with a deadly virus. So the question is, will he find mercy? Is there hope in the horizon? Will he get a second chance? Will he make the right choice this time? And who will respond to his unrequited love? I also wrote an introduction about myself. So I am a family physician, and I am also not just doing clinic visits, but before the pandemic, I also do house visits, especially for elderly patients or those who can no longer go to the hospital for treatment. So if I'm not doing those medical things, maybe you can find me, as I wrote here, on the basketball court, on the beach, maybe in a public park. You might also see me at a karaoke bar if you're lucky. But as I mentioned here, writing is a passion and also a very good form of relaxation, and I think it's also very good for discovering yourself and what your inner feelings are. It's really very challenging to be able to complete writing a book, and it's also different for poetry because there has to be a mood that probably needs to be set in order for you to complete something like a book on poetry. But it's also fulfilling in a way because this is my first foray into self-publishing, and it's just one of the bucket list, I guess. I have already accomplished things in my career, but this is something that's really it's really worth the effort, and it's great when there are those who appreciate the content. And when they say that they learn things about life by reading the book, it's great. No? It really makes the effort worthwhile. Okay, so I guess with those two excerpts, I would like to thank again the romance writers of the Philippines for inviting PaperKat Books and for inviting me to this writing convention. So this virtual convention, I hope, will be a yearly thing, and I hope that everyone has a good time, and I really look forward to more activities from all of you romance writers. So thank you very much. God bless everyone. And again, enjoy the rest of your day. Bye.